Why spend a lot of time and energy creating an animation that you don't know what it will look like? Sure, we know Animate different. With a little skill, it produces quite interesting results. However, by combining Animate Diff with ControlNet, we can specify the motion to create. In this video, you learn how to install the necessary extensions for Animate Diff and ControlNet, which custom models work well, what parameters I choose, and what challenges need to be overcome. Let's start. As user interface for Stable Diffusion, we use Automatic 1111 Web UI. In order to create and control animations, we need two extensions, AnimateDiff and ControlNet. Let's start with installing AnimateDiff. By the way, you find all links in the description below. So we copied the URL for AnimateDiff. And in the web UI, in the extensions tab, we paste the URL and press install. Well, I have already installed AnimateDiff on my machine, so I won't install it again. The next extension to install is ControlNet. By the way, if you want to see more videos about ControlNet, see my videos about upscale and phase swap. The links are in the description below. So here we are on the web page for ControlNet. And this is the URL to install this extension. Again, we switch to the extensions tab, paste the URL and install. And again, I have installed it already on my machine, so I won't do it again. Now you can just check for updates. Yeah, on my machine, there is one for ControlNet. And we say apply and quit. If it doesn't reload immediately, please check if your Stable Diffusion backend has to be restarted too. Now we need the model files for both extensions. By searching for Hugging Face, we find the link to the AnimateDiff repository. And there in motion module, we have the version 3 of the motion checkpoint. The model files for ControlNet are in Ilias Wiehl's ControlNet account. You should download at least the SD15 OpenPose PTH file. Now we will download to Stable Diffusion 1.5 custom model files. These models are much better suited for animation than the original Stable Diffusion 1.5. The first one is Minor Mix, which is great for anime, and anime in general is much better suited for animation than some, well, real life models. Nevertheless, I want to show you a realistic animation, so we require Epic Realism 2. Just download the Safe Tensor model file. Let's quickly move the downloaded files. First, we take care of the customized Stable Diffusion model files. And as usual, we put them into Stable Diffusion, Models, Stable Diffusion. I have already both files, so I will just replace them. Then the ControlNet file for OpenPose. We put it into Stable Diffusion. Extensions, ControlNet, Models. Yes, I already have it, just replace. Now the AnimateDiff model file. We put it again into Extensions, AnimateDiff, Model. Replace. Now let's reload the UI in order to make sure that the moved files can be found. If you have any trouble, you need to restart the backend too. At first we'll create a short animation based on the Minamix anime model file. We just put there the prompt and the negative prompt. No need to change the rest of the parameters for the picture generation. Just make sure to set width and height to same value. Best is 512. In the animate div section, we have to choose the downloaded motion module. I usually enable MP4 for generation, and we have to enable animate div. We leave FPS at 8, and as we want to generate 4 seconds, we enter 32 as number of frames. The first GIF will be without ControlNet, so we just start the generation. Please don't be surprised that I didn't take a screen capturing of the generation. The generation took up all my PC's resources. I couldn't even move the mouse pointer anymore. A few numbers for comparison. I have an 8-core CPU, 32GB RAM, and an AMD Radeon 6800 with 16GB VRAM. 4 seconds of animation takes about 14 minutes at 16fps and about 20 minutes at 30fps. So if you try it yourself, make sure you have coffee or tea and enough time. By the way, if you want to see more videos like this, press the subscribe button. The generation has worked, but the movement is quite bad and for sure not what we have expected. We can definitely improve that. Now it's time to add some control. I've created a small video which we will use to control the movement of our mage. After loading that vid, the number of frames and FPS are automatically set to the correct values. I had no idea how a mage behaves, so I just did something. In the ControlNet parameter section, another video could be added, but if we leave it empty, then the one from animate div is taken. We enable the ControlNet extension and select low VRAM, because then the move motion module is using the CPU. Without this parameter, sometimes I ran into trouble. We choose open pose with the model we have just downloaded and preprocessor. Well, I usually use OpenPose full. No need to change anything else, so we can just start the generation. Along with ControlNet, AnimateDiff encountered an error on my PC. The solution I'm going to show you works the same in the Windows shell as it does in the Linux shell. And if you enjoyed the video so far, please leave a like or a comment. In case you have same error, then here is a solution. Latest ControlNet version does not work together with AnimateDiff. So there is a solution, and we just have to roll back to an older version of ControlNet. Nevertheless, don't do it in case you do not have exactly this error. We open the last working commit of ControlNet, copy the code, enter the ControlNet directory in the Stable Diffusion extensions, and here we do a git checkout of the commit we have just copied. The output might look a bit different on your machine, as I have already tested the whole thing before. Now we do a git fetch and we are done. By the way, you can roll back to the version you have originally installed by using the commands to the left. After applying the bug fix, the generation worked. And the movement is very close to what I was doing. Creating animations with a realistic stable diffusion model is much more difficult. Nevertheless, we try with the epic realism model. We just modify the sampling method and the sampling steps. Well, we select 30. Nothing else to be changed, so let's start. Again, the movement is very similar to what I was doing in the control width. Regarding the lights, well, I guess there are some invisible torches in the castle.